السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of CII Radio, we present to you lesson number 557 of our daily Nasiha. Our topic today is Arafat. Imagine 124,000 Sahaba, Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam there. And what were they doing? Reading Labbaik Allahumma Labbaik. And remember Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam said the hadith in Tirmidhi, Du'a'i wa du'a'ul anbiya min qabli. The dua of mine and the dua of all the messengers and prophets before me, because every Nabi from Nabi Adam alayhi salatu salam performed a hajj and came to Arafat. What is the dua? Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah wa ashhadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. So these type of duas were read by Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we should remember that tawheed, the oneness, and belief in Almighty Allah jalla wa ala, that is the greatest action. And then we find that Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the ummah to engage in their own personal duas. Therefore, when sunset takes place in Arafat, then we leave the plains of Arafat without reading Maghrib Salat and proceed towards Muzdalifah. But the heart should bear testimony, oh beloved Allah, I have made so much tawbah and repented. Definitely your mercy has enveloped me and enveloped us, and our duas are accepted. The question comes, why Arafat? If a person does not go out to Arafat in the state of Ihram and in the afternoon is not there at all, then the Hajj is not done. So it shows that why did Almighty Allah select Arafat? When Almighty Allah Jalla wa Ala in Alam Arwah, the realm, the world of the souls and spirits and the ruh, Almighty Allah asked and posed the question, Alastu bi Rabbikum? Am I not your sustainer, Narisha? Qalu bala. So every one of the ruh said, why not? You are our sustainer, Narisha, provider. So Almighty Allah took that pledge and covenant from this ruh and souls there in Wadi and Na'man. Wadi Na'man is the plains of Arafat. This hadith is mentioned in Musnad Ahmad on the authority of Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhumah. Therefore, O Hujjaj Baytillah, we go to the plains of Arafat to renew our pledge, our promise to Almighty Allah. Therefore, I tell the Hajis, O Haji, try and finish your Quran Sharif on the 9th of Zilhijjah, there on the plains of Arafat, and read your last 5-10 surahs there. Raise your hands and Allah se mangna hai. Then beg Almighty Allah Jalla wala, surely your duas will be accepted. Read Labbaik Allahumma Labbaik. Read the Kalima Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah abundantly and say, Anta Rabbuna, Anta Rabbuna. Ya Allah, I have come here to renew my pledge and covenant with you, O Almighty Allah. Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in that memorable khutbah there at Masjid Namira, remember, said, Fal yuballighu shahidu minkum al-ghaib. Those of you who are present here today, take and deliver and convey this message to humanity for posterity. O Ummah, from Makkah Mukarrama we bring the Zamzam, from Medina Munawwara we bring the Mubarak blessed dates. What do we bring from Arafat? Take this message from Arafat and say, I will convey this message of Islam, the Nurani message, the message of light, radiance and effulgence of Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to all four parts of the world. Then the Master sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Sahaba, they left after sunset, went to Muzdalifah and spent the night there, combined Maghrib and Isha there, picked up 7 pebbles there, and remember you can pick up more pebbles as well. Nabi sallallahu gave the women and old people permission to leave after midnight, but the Master himself sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spent the night there, then read Fajr Salat there in Muzdalifah and made wukuf of Muzdalifah. Yesterday was wukuf of Arafat, so that morning, Saturday morning, the Master alayhi wa sallam made wukuf of Muzdalifah before sunrise, left Muzdalifah back to Mina. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.